In this video, we're going to explore the performance improvement and schema simplicity of RTQP, or real-time query processing, versus PyOLEDB Enterprise. Let's begin by opening PySQL Commander. In this video, we're going to use the WinForm database as it is a sufficiently large enough AF testing database to show performance differences between RTQP and PyOLEDB Enterprise. I've prepared two queries, one for PyOLEDB Enterprise and one for RTQP, so let's begin by opening that file now. Each of these queries return the same output, which is the element name, the path and name of the attribute, the value type for the attribute, and the unit of measure. Right away, we can see the query simplicity of PySQL Client versus that of PyOLEDB Enterprise. For PySQL Client, everything we need is contained within the attribute table, whereas for PyOLEDB Enterprise, we need to join two different tables to the element table to get what we're looking for. This is an artifact of the denormalized nature of the RTQP schema versus that of the highly normalized nature of the PyOLEDB Enterprise schema. I would like to run these queries side by side, so I'm going to copy the PySQL client to a new window. Now let's connect to both of our data sources so that we can run the queries. Here we see the WinForm database. For PySQL client, let's create a new connection specifically for this database. Great, now let's assign the connections to each of the query windows. We'll right-click on the RTQP one and select Connection, and then the RTQP connection. For the OLEDB Enterprise, we'll do the same thing, but select the AF server. Now let's run the OLEDB Enterprise query. Now let's look at the execution time. This query took almost 21.5 seconds to return the first row, and an additional few seconds to return all the rows, totaling up to 377,000. Now let's repeat this process for the RTQP version. Notice that we started seeing results almost immediately, and it only took less than 5 seconds to return the whole thing. The execution time of the query was 0.48 seconds, and it took almost 5 seconds to return all 377,000 rows. There are two different concepts that are combining to produce this result. The first is that the query execution is done server-side for the RTQP query, however, the execution is done client-side for the PyOLEDB Enterprise query. Because of this, the execution is substantially faster overall for the RTQP component than it is for the PyOLEDB Enterprise component. The RTQP version has a direct connection to the PyFD database on the SQL server hosting the AF backend database, whereas PyOLEDB Enterprise, as its client-side, does not have this direct connection. The second item in play is the paging of the results. Since the execution is done server-side and the client is simply receiving the result set, as soon as some of the results are ready, they can be sent over to the client, which can display them immediately. That's why we were able to see results within half of a second, whereas in PyOLEDB Enterprise, the entire result set had to be returned to the client before the result set could be assembled. This means that the first page of results is not available until the entire query is executed. Let's add an order by clause to both queries. This order by clause forces the entire result set to be known by the query engine prior to the ordering to take place, which means that the entire ordering has to occur before the first page of results can be sent to the client. Let's rerun this query and see how much longer it takes to see our first results. The first page was substantially slower to be received, however, it was still a fast execution in general. Now let's do the same thing with PyOLEDB Enterprise. Remember from last time that it took 21.5 seconds to get their first result and almost 25 seconds total to get all of them. If we look at the execution times again, we see 21.6 seconds for the first row and 25 seconds for the total. This is not much different from the other query without the order by clause, since the overall query execution plan has not changed much. In both cases, the entire result set had to be returned to the client, and in this case, they were simply ordered by the unit of measure. It's not much of a difference, and so we don't see much of a difference in the time it takes to receive the first result. Then the overall time to receive the entire result set is also not much of a difference. Hopefully this drives home the idea of what's going on behind the scenes in the different query engines. Next, let's concentrate on the idea of sending pages of results back to the client. To do this, let's get rid of the order by and select just the top 100. This is a substantial decrease in the number of results, where we're going from 377,000 down to just 100. As we execute this query, let's keep in mind that it took 21.6 seconds to get the first row and 25 seconds total. Now let's look at the execution time. We see that it was a little bit faster at 18.3 seconds, and the total time was almost immediately after that, as they only needed to return 100 rows. It still took a very long time to return these 100 rows because, again, the query execution is occurring client-side, so the client has to know the entire result set prior to figuring out which are the top 100, even though they're not ordered. Now let's compare this to the same query in the RTQP version. Remember, in the ordered version, this took almost 3 seconds to get the first row and just over 7 seconds to get the entire result set. Let's execute this query. Now let's look at the execution time. It took just over a third of a second to receive all the rows we were interested in. Now, this is admittedly a contrived query in the fact that we have only 100 rows being returned and we're not in charge of the ordering. In general, this isn't a very desirable SQL query because we're not really in control of which 100 results the query is returning. However, this query really shows the differences between the RTQP engine and the PyOLEDB Enterprise engine. The differences in the execution time is, as I mentioned before, the RTQP engine is returning the results to the client as they're ready. Since this is not an aggregated or an ordered query, we do not need to know the entire result set prior to returning just the 100 rows, and since we're able to return pages of results as they're ready to the client, we're getting a substantially faster execution. In fact, in this specific query, the RTQP query engine is 50 times faster than the PyOLEDB Enterprise query engine. Now, the last thing I'd like to show is the differences in the machine resource consumption for the client application for both RTQP and PyOLEDB Enterprise. Let's return the query to the original state, and let's open up Windows Performance Monitor. Let's create a new display, and let's go to the Process tab so we can add information about the SQL Commander Lite process. Let's add processor time, as well as private bytes. And let's click OK. Let's change private bytes to something a little bit more readable and add a couple zeros. Now let's run the query for RTQP. Query's finished, and we see a jump in the private bytes, which represents the memory usage for the PySQL Commander Lite process, as well as percent processor time. Let's run the PyOLEDB Enterprise query. Here we see the memory consumption during the RTQP execution and the memory consumption during the PyOLEDB Enterprise query execution. We also see the percent processor time going way up just for a short amount of time for RTQP versus a longer amount of time for the PyOLEDB Enterprise execution. As we can see, there's a substantially higher amount of machine resources being consumed in the execution of the PyOLEDB Enterprise query versus that of the RTQP query. This is again due to the client-side execution of PyOLEDB Enterprise versus the server-side execution of RTQP. Now, in this environment, the client machine is also the server machine, so we're not removing any resources from the machine itself. However, in your environment, if you're using a different machine for the client application as you are for any of your servers, then the concept of moving the machine resources off of the client machine and onto the server might show you an actual noticeable difference. Finally, one thing not shown here, since it is all on one machine, is the network resources. Since only the result set is being returned, the network resources are substantially lower for the RTQP version as they are for the PyOLEDB Enterprise version, which is using the AF SDK to return all the results and then building the result set client-side. Not only will you notice a reduction in machine resources, but also in network bandwidth usage.